Earth, the beautiful planet we live on, has a delicate and thin atmosphere that makes us survive on this blue planet. Today's video talks about why we have one and some other interesting facts about our atmosphere. Fact number one, atmosphere's thickness. If you take an apple and hypothetically say it's the same size as the Earth, if you look at the atmosphere's thickness and compare it to the size of the entire Earth, that ratio is equivalent to the apple's skin thickness compared to the size of the apple. Yes, that thin. And because of this delicate and thin layer, we're able to breathe on our planet. Fact number two, escaping our atmosphere on Earth. If you take a ball and throw it up in the air, it'll reach a maximum height and eventually come back down from where you threw it. But if you now throw the ball a little faster than before, it'll reach a higher height, but again, eventually come back down. Now what if I ask you, is there a speed at which if you threw the ball fast enough that it will just keep going and never come back or escape the Earth and its atmosphere? Well, that speed is actually called the escape speed. Engineers like to say velocity because it makes them sound smarter. Velocity is just speed with direction associated to it. So at the escape speed, the object escapes the Earth and its atmosphere. That escape speed is actually a whopping 25,000 miles an hour. Now that is fast. That speed is 50 times faster than what a commercial airline flies at. And at that speed, you would reach New York from California in just 7 minutes. Which brings us to fact number three. Why do we even have an atmosphere? Well, it has to do with this escape velocity. If you break down what the atmosphere is made up of, you'll find it's mostly nitrogen, oxygen, and some other gases in very little amounts. So in our atmosphere, molecules of nitrogen and oxygen, or just simply air molecules, move around very fast, all the time. But the average speed these air molecules move at is around 1100 miles an hour, approximately, which is much smaller than the escape velocity of the Earth. So these air molecules remain trapped due to the Earth's gravity. And this is why the Earth retains an atmosphere. And on the other hand, our moon has no atmosphere because the escape velocity of the moon is much slower than the Earth due to its smaller size and less gravitational pull. And air molecules on the moon eventually escaped and disappeared, resulting in no atmosphere on it. And finally, fact number four. How high do airplanes fly in an atmosphere? Although the atmosphere is defined to end at the Kármán line, which is 62 miles from sea level, commercial airlines fly at a maximum height of up to 8 miles. That's because going higher than 8 miles, the atmosphere becomes too thin for planes to keep lift or stay up in the air. And it's not fuel efficient for airlines to fly above that height. Or of course, it has to do with money. So when you look up from the airplane's window at cruising altitude at the highest leg of your journey, now you know that you still have 54 miles remaining to get to the boundary of the atmosphere. And you're about 8 miles high from ground level. And of course, you can thank our atmosphere for that breathtaking view. And please, don't open the window. It's freezing out there. Thanks for watching this learnability video. Keep on learning.